before this decade is out, of landing a man on the moon and returning him safely to the Earth.
All is in readiness for the launch of Apollo 11 from Cape Kennedy. Mission Control at the Cape reports the countdown is proceeding on schedule. Astronauts Armstrong, Aldrin, and Collins have suited up and ingressed the command module aboard this 363-foot-high Saturn Apollo configuration. Weather is satisfactory at the Cape. It is estimated that about 1 million tourists are now converging toward the beaches for the launch.
12, 11, 10, 9, ignition sequence start. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0, all engine running. Liftoff. We have a liftoff. 32 minutes past the hour. Liftoff on Apollo 11. Tower cleared.
We got a roll from here. Neil Armstrong reporting the roll and pitch program, which puts Apollo 11 on a proper heading. Plus 30 seconds. Altitude's 2 miles.
Well, in Houston, you're good at 1 minute.
Downrange 1 mile, altitude 3-4 miles now. Velocity 2,195 feet per second. -0-5-4-8-7. Foresight star Shala. Left 008 down. -2605-02500. 11229-33993-0125535. Still there?
I'm going.
Okay. Dead up in Vega, 067-283-337, no alerts.
I'm sure you see the orbital elements again.
Madrid AOS. Madrid AOS.
Early communications was noisy but readable. Mission Control was able to hear the voices of the crew shortly after the tracking station at Madrid, Spain, acquired the telemetry signals.
Apollo 11 is getting its first view of the landing approach.
The Apollo 11 Lunar Module Eagle has begun its descent toward the surface of the moon. The descent stage engine of the Eagle was fired at about 9 minutes, 2 p.m. Central Daylight Time. The engine burn time was less than 29 seconds. The engine firing places the lunar module into a slowly descending orbit. Meanwhile, astronaut Collins in the command module Columbia maintains a constant vigil on the descending lunar module. Communications have remained good with both Eagle and Columbia. The planned touchdown is for 3:17 p.m. in an area called landing site number 2.
30 feet down, 2.5. Picking up some dust. 30 feet, 2.5 down. Take that out. Fall forward, drift into the right a little. Ready? 2.5.
Carnarvon
has started tracking, and we will start processing.
Hey.
Contact light. Okay, engine stop. APA at a descent. Earth control boat auto descent, engine command override off. Engine arm on. 413 is in.
Descent and landing. Lunar module, while on the surface of the moon, is being referred to now as Tranquility Base. Astronaut Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin are preparing to step onto the lunar surface this evening. Preparations for the extravehicular activities are running a little behind schedule. Special display has been set up in the auditorium of Building 8 at the Goddard Space Flight Center during the flight of Apollo 11. A wide variety of displays includes models of the Apollo 11 command module and lunar module, an animated Apollo 11 mission profile, and information on the manned space flight network, the vital communications link required for the Apollo mission. Goddard employees are invited to bring their family and friends to see the display. Hours of the open house are from 10 a.m. until 8 p.m. daily throughout the Apollo 11 mission. In addition, visitors may watch operations of the real-time computer center, NASCOM, and SCAMA through the viewing windows in Building 14.
NASA brings together the scholars and scientists of our universe for research and technological skill of our great industry. The will of the people, and focus on whatever job needs to be done.
The largest part of the lunar module, the LM on left. The ground is woven from a standing position, the LM pilot to the right, the command pilot to the left. These are the commander's controllers. His right hand is on the attitude controller, regulating pitch.
Astronaut Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin are preparing to step onto the lunar surface. Armstrong will leave the cabin first. TV viewers around the world will be able to see Armstrong be the first human to set foot on another celestial body.
Goldstone, Apollo.
Goldstone, got a voice. Would you meet me on that one for voice check, please?
All right.
Okay, I just checked getting back up to that first step.
One small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
Surface is fine and buttery. I can pick it up loosely with my toe. It does adhere in fine layers.
Funny circle,
got a
voice,
that's great. To the
circle. How's your TV looking now?
I only go in
Oh, roger.
I can't see the ace of an inch, but I can see the footprint of my boots and the treads and the fine sandy particles.
White House, Goddard voice.
White House.
Oh, roger, White House, Goddard voice. How do you hear me?
You're loud and clear, sir. How many?
Oh, you're loud and clear also. We'll be extending this circuit now into the Apollo net at Goddard for the presidential call to Tranquility Base.
Roger, thank you.
Thank you. Got a voice out.
Neil and Buzz, the President of the United States is in his office now and would like to say a few words to you. Over. Go ahead, Mr. President. This is Houston out.
Hello, Neil and Buzz. I'm talking to you by telephone from the Oval Room at the White House. And this certainly has to be the most historic telephone call ever made. I just can't tell you how proud we all are of what you do. For every American, this has to be the proudest day of our lives. And for people all over the world, I am sure they too join with the in recognizing what an immense feat this is. Because of what you have done, the heavens have become a part of man's world. And as you talk to us from the Sea of Tranquility, it inspires us to redouble our efforts to bring peace and tranquility to Earth. For one priceless moment, in the whole history of man, all of the people on this earth are truly one. One in their pride in what you have done. And one in our prayers that you will return safely to Earth.
Thank you, Mr. President. It's a great honor and privilege for us to be here representing not only the United States, but and of peace of all nations, and with interest and a curiosity and with a vision for the future. Honor for us to be able to participate here today.
And thank you very much, and I look forward, all of us look forward to seeing you on the Hornet on Thursday.
Forward to that very much, sir. Columbia, Columbia, this is Houston, over.
Two groups at the Goddard Space Flight Center are waiting for samples of the moon rocks that will be brought back by astronauts Armstrong and Aldrin. The scientists, headed up by Dr. Isidore Adler of the Theoretical Studies branch and Dr. John Philpotts of the Planetology branch, will be among some 140 experimenters from the United States and foreign countries to receive the samples after they have gone through quarantine and prepared for distribution by the Lunar Receiving Laboratory of the Houston Manned Spacecraft Center.
The samples out here, the hard rock samples, have what appear to be vesicles in the surface. Also, I'm looking at one now that appears to have some sort of fingerprints.
Hey, Neil, didn't I say we might see some purple rocks?
Find the purple rocks?
Yep.
At approximately 11:53 p.m. Central Daylight Time tonight, astronauts Neil Armstrong and Buzz Aldrin began preparations to re-enter the lunar module.
The Eagle lifted off the surface of the moon at 12:54 p.m. Central Daylight Time today.
Apollo 11 is on the way home.
Apollo 11 is streaking toward a splashdown in the Pacific Ocean. The speed will rapidly increase to a maximum of about 24,800 miles per hour. 400,000 feet above the Earth, the spacecraft will begin to encounter the atmosphere. At that point, the heat shield will begin to heat up.
5-6, this is Sydney Garrett.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Captain Brownstein from the flight deck of Qantas 596. It does seem that we're going to get a very good view of Apollo 11. Oh, I think, here they come, on the left side. Two of them, one object brighter than the other. See the two of them, one above the other? Brightest one, lowest. One's the command module, one's the service module. They each weigh 6 tons. They're just picking up heat now. The bottom one's leaving an incandescent trail. You see it flashing? That's a trail of epoxy ablative resin coating. See it brightening up? What a spectacle. It's passing a Bemis now at nearly 300 miles. Good.
Apollo 11 with astronauts Neil Armstrong, Edwin Aldrin, and Michael Collins has splashed down in the Pacific Ocean. A historic voyage to the moon and back ended at 11:50 a.m. Central Daylight Time. The landing took place at a point about 900 miles southwest of Hawaii. As the spacecraft re-entered the atmosphere, one of the recovery planes sighted the spacecraft glowing in the early morning sky. Shortly before splashdown, another of the instrumented aircraft spotted Apollo 11. Then the spacecraft was spotted briefly behind the clouds by those on the recovery ship Hornet. At 11:45, the Apollo 11 crew reported that the chutes had deployed. At 11:48, the Hornet reported visual sighting. Then the Apollo 11 itself reported.
Apollo 11, this is Hornet, over.
Apollo 11, over. Our position is 6915.
Helicopters immediately began to hover over the Apollo 11, and then swimmers dropped into the water for the recovery.
Hornet, Goddard voice by ATS.
So Hornet, go ahead.
Roger, you're loud and clear. How do you read me?
Copy, you're loud and clear.
Roger, we're going to be monitoring this circuit for the recovery sequence. We'll also be extending this circuit onto the White House.
Roger, understand.
White House, Goddard voice.
White House.
Roger, how do you hear me?
You're loud and clear.
Roger, you're loud and clear also. We'll be extending this circuit into the Apollo and heading Goddard. Thank you very much.
President Nixon waving to the astronauts. The curtains have been drawn. There they are in the rear window. The president signals for applause from the crowd. Astronauts gather in the window.
Neil, Buzz, and Mike, I want you to know that I think I'm the luckiest man in the world. And I say this not only because I have the honor to be President of the United States, but particularly because I have the privilege of speaking for so many and welcoming you back to Earth. I can tell you about all the messages we've received in Washington. Over 100 foreign governments, emperors and presidents and prime ministers and kings have sent the most warm messages that we've ever received. They represent over 2 billion people on this earth, all of them who have had the opportunity through television to see what you have done. All this we pray as our thanksgiving rings out to thee in the name of our Lord. Amen.
Amen.